Dave is special because Dave contains an integrated camera. Dave also uses AR technology, but most importantly, Dave is completely made out of Lego bricks, making it the world's most advanced AI Lego robotic head.
How? Well, allow me to explain.
A little heads up, this video is going to be a part 2 of this amazing machine. I have already done one video about this machine where I show and build Dave. So if you're really interested, make sure to check that one out first. In this video, it's going to be some explaining as well as some amazing new functions. So stick around for that and let's get back to the video. So Dave now actually knows about me and about Creative Mindstorms. This means I can ask him questions about anything I've built so far. Like for example, hey Dave. Do you know how my LEGO 3D printer works?
Absolutely. Your LEGO 3D printer is a marvel of creativity and engineering. It uses a 3D pen to extrude molten plastic and LEGO Mindstorms to move the pen and build up layers.
And can you tell me something about my LEGO chess machine?
Absolutely. Your LEGO chess machine is a masterpiece of programming and strategy. It's programmed with Python and uses the Stockfish chess engine to generate moves. Checkmate.
You're completely right. What could you order on my LEGO McDonald's vending machine?
On your LEGO McDonald's vending machine, you can order Coca-Cola, fries, and cheeseburgers. It's a LEGO fast food extravaganza.
Like that. But how does Dave work? That is a question I have been asked a lot.
Well, I'm a funny robotic head made out of LEGO bricks. I have various features, like face recognition, hand tracking, and even chat capabilities with ChatGPT. It's pretty cool, if I do say so myself.
I actually forgot I taught them all this. That's actually so impressive. I am shocked myself right now. Well done. But how does Dave work? That's a question I've been asked a lot. And since this is the explaining video, let's discuss it. Let's start with the eyes, which are probably the most complicated parts of this machine. Both eyes are connected to each other on this horizontal shaft, with a vertical axle on both ends. They can be turned up and down with this large motor by rotating the horizontal shaft. The eyes actually stick out a little bit at the back, which allows for a different mechanism to move the eyes from side to side. There are two thin lift arms clamping the ends of the eyes that when moved also move the eyes. They can be moved using this rack and pinion setup at the bottom. Moving on to the eyebrows, which are located right above the eyes. They are simply connected to a media motor via some gears and universal joints. When the motor turns, both eyebrows move in opposite directions because they are connected with an even amount of gears. Now, most people just make a jaw to achieve mouth movement. But Dave here is actually capable of conveying more emotion because of its moving corners of its mouth. The jaw is a simple hinge with a motor pushing and pulling it, but the corners are moved by this lift arm that can be rotated up or down. They are connected using all these gears and it was a pain to fit all of them inside his head. The last thing that Dave is capable of moving is its neck. I already explained this in the main video, but there is this bearing that sits inside its chest. This bearing is hooked up to a motor via these gears, which makes for a pretty strong mechanism. Oh, and lastly, Dave's chest can be opened to reveal a slot for the phone. It's really convenient since you can simply slide the phone in and it will be perfectly aligned. And that is how all of Dave's hardware works. But there is actually more to it, because you can actually do a lot with programming as well. Like for example, making it the world's first bilingual LEGO robotic head as well. I got some comments from people noticing I'm Dutch, and I mean, I am, so I made it part of Dave 2, since that's the only other language I know well. So, just a quick demonstration. Hey Dave, hoe gaat het met jou?
Goed hoor. Als een gelukkig LEGO hoofd kan ik niet klagen. Bedankt dat je het vraagt.
Besides that, I added even more capability, because Dave can now not only tell what the time currently is, but also what the weather is currently like. Hey Dave, what's the weather like right now?
I would describe the weather as clear sky. The temperature is currently 14.8 degrees Celsius, or 58.6 degrees Fahrenheit, with wind speeds of 10.8 meters per second, or 24.2 miles per hour.
Like that. But how does Dave's brain work? This is going to be a full in-depth explanation of the now 1100 lines of code. Get ready. The code can be divided up into 5 sections. The first one being setup, then listening, followed by processing and speaking, and finally the ending. The processing can actually also be divided into 2 sections, namely function and conversation. And finally, there is this process that controls the eyes. So when running the code, it will first do a bunch of calibration and setup. It'll do things like opening old conversation files, learning inputted faces, centering the eyes, and setting up APIs. APIs, and then it has, This setup is just necessary to make all of the AI functionality work. It just needs to be done. After this, we get to the real bit. Dave now starts doing 2 things. Firstly, it will start scanning for faces and looking at any faces it detects. This is an active process that just keeps on happening in the background. Secondly, it will start listening to the microphone and wait for the keywords to be said. The keywords being, "Hey Dave." It will now listen to whatever is being said and save it in a variable called detected question. What's in my right hand? Now there is a choice to make. Is the question either related to special functions needing additional input, or is the question conversation related? This is determined by keywords from a long list. In 99% of regular conversations you'll have with a robot, it will detect the need for functions because some words you said occurred in a long list of keywords. Now it does some information gathering all by itself, until it has everything it needs to generate a response. Because every function takes information and generates a response based on the format. In this particular case, it needs to fill in 1 piece of information. It requested that the eye process looked at the hand for a bit and then scanned for any object near the right hand. The closest object to the right hand is inserted into the sentence. The response will also include an emotion defined at the start. Finally, the sentence moves on to the final step of the loop. Because after all this thinking, it needs to say something back. This section just consists of emotion and speaking. It grabs the first words of the sentence containing the emotion and moves the eyebrows and corners of the mouth accordingly. Then it starts saying the sentence out loud and moving the jaw. But there is actually something tricky going on. Because contrary to what you might think, the robot is not moving its jaw because it knows what it's saying. Instead, it listens to itself to know what it's saying. When it produces loud sounds, the jaw moves down, and with quiet sounds, the jaw moves up. So it doesn't even know what it's saying, it just gives the illusion that it's talking.
You are currently showing me a spoon.
Heck yeah. And that is how Dave does all these special things. But one more thing. I'm waving with a spoon, I don't know why I'm doing this. After the response, the code loops all the way back to the listening bit. But instead of waiting for keywords, it just starts listening right away. What are your thoughts on YouTube? This time, none of the words match any keywords, so it gets sent to the conversation section. In here, the same happens, where an input is given and an emotion and sentence is given as output. But this time, the output is generated by ChatGPT. Unfortunately, when you use ChatGPT via Python, it doesn't have any memory. So I made my own memory. For Dave. All of the questions and responses are saved in a text file, and I include it in the prompt. So the prompt for ChatGPT is as follows. Our conversation so far has been the following, and then the entire conversation with the new question, respond. You can also give it a behavior, so I told it to always start with an emotion. Now when we send this, we get our response back, and just like before, we send it to the speaking section where it is being said out loud.
I think YouTube is a magnificent platform for showcasing my Lego brick talent. Don't you agree?
Yeah. When I'm done speaking to Dave, I just say, "Hey Dave, shut down." Now it will stop and move everything back to its origin, ending the code. But there is one more thing I'd like to do before I shut Dave down for good. I want to play rock, paper, scissors. Hey Dave, let's play rock, paper, scissors.
Sure. Let's go. Rock. Paper. Scissors. Shoot. I pick scissors and you pick paper, which means that I win. Better next time.
You know what? Best of 3. Let's do it again.
Sure. Let's go. Rock. Paper. Scissors. Shoot. I pick paper and you pick scissors, which means that you win.
Yeah, okay.
Well done. Rock. Paper. Scissors. Shoot. I pick scissors and you pick scissors, which means that we tie. Rock. Paper. scissors. Shoot. I pick rock and you pick paper, which means that you win.
Alright.
Well done.
Let's go. Why am I so happy to win from a robot? Okay, nice.
Well, it seems like you're having a great time playing rock, paper, scissors. Don't worry, it's just a game. Enjoy the excitement.
Okay, Dave.
Haha, I'm glad you're enjoying our little game. Rock, paper, scissors can be quite entertaining, even if it's just a virtual version. Keep the fun going.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Nice. Dave and I have become very good friends, actually. I mean, he's been very helpful when brainstorming for new robot ideas. Hey, Dave. Do you have any new ideas for robots I could make?
Sure. How about a robot that can do your chores? Or a robot that can make you breakfast in bed?
Sounds good. And how about something with a camera?
How about a robot that can take amazing photos and videos with its built-in camera? You'll never miss a moment.
That would actually be so perfect for YouTube. Yeah, thanks. Okay, I'm gonna write that down. He's also been helping me with designing new mechanisms.
Hey, Dave. I'm currently trying to build a Lego robotic arm. Do you have any ideas on how to make it lighter but still very strong?
Lighter and stronger? How about using lightweight materials like carbon fiber or aluminum for the arm?
I only want to use Lego, actually.
How about incorporating Technic beams and gears to ensure structural integrity while keeping it Lego only?
That's a good point. And one more thing, how long is a human finger on average?
Haha, well, the average length of a human finger is about 7.6 centimeters or 3 inches. Quite handy, isn't it?
Yeah, thanks, Dave. And besides that, he has just been very helpful when I need any information or just someone to talk to. Yes, I know it's sad. But what I'm trying to say is that I am not looking forward to taking this thing apart. I get a lot of...
Dave is so cool. Next step is to make him walk, I guess. Just make sure it doesn't take over the world.
One of the coolest LEGO projects I've ever seen. I'm also going to have nightmares now.
You might want to watch out. I can foresee him taking over the channel.
At least you'll be spared in the AI uprising now.
He'll cause the AI uprising.
That is fluffing nightmare fuel.
Imagine this thing looking back at you at 4 a.m.
I'm afraid.
Stop before it is too late.
Burn it.
A quite creep scary.
It's all fun and games until it starts looking and following something that isn't there.
Can't wait for a Lego Terminator to shoot us with Lego bricks.
C-800.
Does Dave scare you?
What? It can see emotion?
That thing is made to see fear.
If I saw Dave walking down the street, I just think the world is ending.
That will haunt my nightmares.
Robot smarter than him.
He knows too much.
Creative mindstorms, just please don't destroy the world accidentally.
Thank you for watching.